The Lucian Peoples Movement has taken a realistic approach, saying that it will not field 17 candidates for the upcoming election, acknowledging that certain constituencies are either SLP or UWP strongholds. At the same time, the LPM has been considering potential candidates, some of whom, according to the LPM, does not fit the party's criteria. However, the LPM is extending an invitation to persons who think that they have something good to offer and are interested in contesting the election on an LPM ticket.
And so we want to make an appeal to anyone out there who believe that they are honest, who believe they can make a major difference in terms of this country, to step forward and offer yourself as a candidate for the Lucian Peoples Movement. We have a short window here to close, and we need to be able to, within the next couple of weeks, a few weeks or so, to be able to state clearly what seats we are going to contest. We have a clear idea what we are going to do, but we want to open up the process to those out there who believe that they have a contribution to make, who believe that they can take this country better.
Traditionally, third parties do not fare well, and in all the previous cases have fallen by the wayside. So what is different about the LPM that would help it to make its mark? A question we put to the leader. His response is that the LPM is the only third party that has lost an election and yet continues to lobby on behalf of the people. Additionally, according to Prudent, the movement has already undertaken initiatives that would provide employment for the youth.
At the end of the day, the young person on the street, there's hope. Most of our young people aren't thinking red or yellow. That doesn't matter to them. What's matter to them the most is opportunity, advancement, social advancement, opportunity for scholarships, opportunity for job creation. That's what they're interested in. Not in the politics of their mother, not in the politics of their grandmother, the politics of what will satisfy them and fulfill what they really want here in this country.
The chairman of the LPM lamented the state of the economy and thinks that the LPM has what it takes to reverse the situation.
What has happened in the past with the two major parties have, for the last, if we have to reflect back on the last 10 years, it has been politically disastrous for St. Lucia in respect of name, in respect of what progress has any of the parties have achieved, in easing up the burden and the economic strain on St. Lucians. Right now we are suffering with the whole idea of, money has less value, the cost of living is quite strenuous on the lives of St. Lucians. So, LPM has been out there providing this participatory politics. People, whatever ideas you have, and we can go out and listen to what you have to say. And we have been providing St. Lucians with policies on job creations.
According to Mr. Prudence's statistics, the Groslay constituency has an electorate of 25,000, but according to him, only 9,000 have voted over the past two decades. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.